Hey, Parish family. In this session of Catholicism 101, Why Am I Catholic? We talked about prayer and relationship. Right, last time we spoke about baptism, which brings us into relationship with God. And this time we spoke about what does that relationship look like and how do I pray? We basically spoke about comparing relationship in a natural way to the relationship with God, right? When you have a relationship with a person, you don't come with a set of checklists and say, this is what I have to do, and therefore if I do these things, then I'm gonna get something out of it. No, you walk in and you say, hey, what do you like to eat? What do you like to drink? All those little things. Now, when we do that with God, it's a little bit different, no? Because we don't ask him, what is he like? But we start asking questions about ourselves, like, Lord, what do you like about me? When we start to hear the truth of the things that are about us, it starts to push away the negative thoughts about the things I dislike about myself. But it's important to bring those things to God as well. Because in relationships, we bring the good and the bad. We don't just put up a facade and say, this is who I am. But rather, we bring the good and the bad and we say, Lord, here's what I dislike about myself. Why? Because, I don't know, somebody told me that I was this or that when I was a kid and I started to believe it. We start to listen to the truth. But a relationship allows a place for conversation. It takes time and it takes commitment, but it also takes conversation that allows us to enter into truth about who we are and about who the other person is. Right? And this church lays out various ways of prayer, mental prayer, contemplation, etc., Lectio Divina. But in all of those, there's sort of three basic parts of the spiritual life. There's the purgative, the illuminative, and the unitive. And every prayer brings us through those stages. Every prayer. Why? Because the purgative, just like at Mass, what's the first thing we do? We ask the Lord forgiveness for our sins. We begin to ask him to purge us of anything that doesn't belong to him, that's not good or holy or true. So we ask the Lord, Lord, forgive me for my sins. And then the second part of Mass, what do? We ask him to illuminate us with the Word, illuminate our mind with the Word of God, so that we begin to experience the truth of who Jesus is and the truth of who we are. And that takes us to the third stage, which is the unitive, the communion that we receive, being one with God. Communion, to be one with. Right? In every prayer that we pray can have those three parts. Lord, I'm sorry for my sinfulness in this area. Here I ask you to grant me the grace so that you can bring me into union. Because ultimately this is what it's about. Prayer is about entering into union with God. Why? Because that's what heaven's going to be, this perfect contemplation of who God is and who we are. God isn't doing, he's being, right? God is being itself. It's like a father who holds his newborn infant against his chest, or a mother, and they experience this beautiful moment of rest, right? That's how we are with God. God doesn't look at you and be like, hey, you sinned and therefore you failed and you're a failure. No. God looks at you as a child. And when you're learning how to walk and you fall down, they don't yell at you and tell you to, you know, you're worthless, get back up. No. They say, hey, come on. They encourage you. This is what God does with us. We're infants in the spiritual life. We're infants into him. And so he continues to teach us. And it's a trial and error. We live in a society that expects perfection, right? Straight A's. You got to have straight A's. Otherwise, you know, you got to work harder. It's like, no, like, we're going to trial and error in our spiritual life with God. So be patient with yourself and allow him to teach you how to be patient. And I did a prayer exercise with the group that was there, and you can watch it on the longer video. And we close our eyes and we begin to hear the voice of God simply with the tools that he's already given to us, right? We close our eyes and we say our first, middle, and last name. And we hear that voice. And when we hear that voice, that's the voice that God uses to speak to us. He doesn't speak to us often in big, loud, booming voices, but in the simple ways that he's already given to us. And then I ask the question, you close your eyes and you ask the question, Father, do you love me? And what's the first thing that comes to your mind? Many people said yes. Some said absolutely. Some said, you know that I do. Unconditionally. All these various ways that the Lord speaks to us. That's his voice. How do we know if it's our voice or his voice? Well, you know how when you spend time with somebody, you get to hear their voice and you know what they would say and what they wouldn't say? You know those moments? That's how it is with God. We give him time. We begin to hear his voice. We begin asking those questions. We take little moments, little steps of faith that say, I'm going to trust that that was your voice. And I'm going to act on that. And then the last thing that we did was we talked about the imaginative prayer. You close your eyes, you imagine the Christmas tree of your childhood. What do you see? What do you smell? What do you taste? What can you see your family doing this or that? What's on the tree? What's under the tree? What's behind the tree? That's imaginative prayer. You're going back in your imagination to a memory. And God uses that when we go into Scripture or when you just sit with him. Lord, show me an image that you want me to meditate on. Teach me about it. you gnaw in it, you wrestle with it. Israel means wrestling with God, one who wrestles with God. No matter how old we are, we can get into a wrestling match with God and it's okay, because we're wrestling with Him, discovering, what is this prayer? What is this teaching me? Right? And last night at the evening session, we talked about the examine prayer. Right? What is, at the end of the day, I look back and I say, Lord, what are five ways that you blessed me? Five ways that you graced me today? What are three ways that I failed to love you in thought, word, or deed? And what's one thing I'm asking for tomorrow? 5, 3, 1. What's five ways that you blessed me? Three ways that I failed, and one thing I'm asking for tomorrow. Why do we do five ways that He blessed us? Because we have a tendency as human beings to look at our faults more than our affirmations. So we ask the Lord, Lord, you show me five ways that you blessed me. And now show me only three ways that I failed you. I can think of a whole lot more. Yeah, of course, we're humans. But only three. And one way that one thing I'm asking for, a virtue, a grace that I'm asking for tomorrow to get through. Maybe I need more patience. So the Lord sends you to the supermarket the day of the Super Bowl. That'll teach you patience, right? So we do these little things as simple ways of reminding us about God's presence in our life. All right, so I hope that is a simple explanation about prayer, relationship. If you have more questions, always feel free to contact me. Contact your local priest if you can ask questions. Seek somebody that can help you, right? Because we're in about relationship with God. He's brought you into it. You don't have to create something anew. I use the example of Finding Nemo. They had the EAC to get to Australia. They jump into the EAC, the East Australian Current, and they take that right down, and that's what we do. Prayer already exists simply by your being alive, your conception. God created an ability to communicate with you. And so hop into it. Enjoy it. It's a ride. It's an adventure. He's going to take you to places and things in your heart that you either forgot about or that you never thought possible, because the Lord is brilliant and He thinks brilliantly of you. So I hope this helps. You're in my prayers. You're in our prayers. Looking forward to see you guys at the next one next month. God bless you. Bye-bye.